262 POW MIA ceremony, and we will have the singing of the national anthem. Prayer by Marley McLean.
Heavenly Father, as we gather here on this third Friday of September that has been designated as POW MIA Day by the veterans organizations, we ask that you be with us. Bless all the here and all that are present and present. We ask this in your Son's loving name. Amen.
This time I'm going to explain the POW MIA table, what it stands and what it represents. The table is set for one to symbolize the frailty of one prisoner of war alone and against his oppressors. The tablecloth is white. It symbolizes the purity of his intentions to respond to his country's call to arms. The single rose displayed in the vase reminds us of his family and loved ones who keep faith while awaiting his return. The red ribbon right so prominently on the vase is a reminiscent of the red ribbon worn upon the label on the breast of thousands who bear witness to his captivity. It also bears witness to the unyielding determination to demand proper accounting of all our misses. A slice of lemon is on the bread plate to remind us of the bitter fate. There's also salt on this plate. This is symbolic of his family's tears as they wait for his return. The glass is inverted, because he cannot trust with us this night. The candle is a symbol to light their way home. The chair is empty because he cannot be here with us this night. Remember all of you who have served with him and call him comrade, who depended upon his might and aid and relied upon him, for surely he has not forsaken you. He is commonly called a POW MIA. I, like you, just call him friend. He is not able to be with us this evening, so we remember him. We also remember all the other POW and MIAs on this night and wish them God's blessing and love, and above all, we wait their return home. I'd like to introduce our commander, Dean Duck.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I am Dean Duck, commander of the Great Post 7262. Thank you for being here, and a special thanks to Don Dietrich and Marlene McGlinch. Thank you. And for setting this up, and Bach to Rock for the sound system. Please join me in a moment of silence and remembrance with the highest level of respect for the fallen brothers and sisters. It is my pleasure to introduce the great speaker, Department Senior Vice Commander, Don Faulkner.
Good morning, comrades, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of State Commander Bob Giannone, it's an honor to be here today, Greenville Memorial Post 7262. And I want to say that's probably one of the best renditions of the national anthem I've heard in a long time. I'd like to give this lady another round of applause. Sing of that beautifully without company of instruments and tone, magnificent. And Mike, when I'm state commander, I'd like this young lady to come and sing at the convention. Busy we all are, what we do every day. We're busy at school, we're busy at home. But today, one time a year, we need to stand here and remember those who went before us. The dictionary defines a vigil as a state of sacred remembrance. When we come here together in the state of sacred remembrance, we do honor that flag you see flying on the watchtower there. It has at the bottom of it, "You are not forgotten." We know of no POWs that may be in captivity. I can tell you as a fellow aviator, who've known aviators who've been a prisoner of war, knowing that the American people are behind you when you're in that small cell all by yourself at the hands of a captor gives you the strength to return with honor. Today we have 83,000 missing in action. And we, the Veterans of Foreign Wars and the POW-MIA Accounting Agency, will not stop until every one of them is brought home. I ask you to think today, if there's 83,000 missing in action, that means there's families that have 83,000 loved ones. They do not know where they are. And for them, the days become weeks and years trying to bring to that closure. But there's hope. Through efforts of government agencies, they have been returned. I will tell you, in Dayton, Ohio last year, Specialist Ulmer, who was missing in the Korean War, was returned to his mother and buried beside her. And he was found by the efforts of that accounting agency to do that. But today, we remember the families of those who are still waiting for those answers. It is an honor to be here, and I would ask each of us to also, if you would please, remove your covers and take a moment of silence. Those families still waiting for the loved ones to come home. Covered. Marilyn, if you would come up here, please. Marlene, I'm sorry, Marlene. Closing prayer.
Helen.
Almost had it right.
They may find patience to endure and peace in the knowledge of your continuing presence. Amen.
Amen. Okay, thank you for attending. This concludes our ceremony. We'll have Marlene's chicken and noodles in the canteen.